When you start learning shoemaking or making shoes, first thing that you need to master is making basic pattern. What is it basic pattern? Basic pattern is the exact copy of your shoe last. This pattern repeat all curves, all lines of our shoe last. And it must be very precise. Why? Because based on this basic pattern, you will construct most of the different footwear types like Oxford shoes, derby shoes, boots, etc. So that's why this basic pattern must be correct, because if you will make it wrong, all your shoe types will be wrong. So that's why this is the first thing that you need to learn how to do. I already have tutorial about making basic pattern, but this tutorial is very old. I made it 8 years ago. So I decided to upgrade it to explain everything step by step with my verbal explanation, so you will know how to make basic pattern correctly. If you love shoemaking and want to make shoes, make sure to subscribe to this channel, because this channel is all about shoemaking. So subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click the bell button to know when my new video will come out. Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses. Now, if you want to make basic pattern correctly, follow my explanation step-by-step. We start from the covering of our shoe last with masking tape. You can use ordinary masking tape. The width of this masking tape is about 5 centimeters. And now we need to cut long enough strip of masking tape that will cover one half of our shoe last. Why we need to cover only one half? Because it's enough for us to cover only one half of outer side of our shoe last to create basic pattern. So cut masking tape and attach it in the middle of the shoe last along length of the shoe last. Then in the places where we have curved shape of the shoe last, you can make cut in order to attach our masking tape to the surface of the shoe last. It's important to avoid creation of tiny folds, so you can spread all folds with your fingers or with the knife, the side of the knife, okay? With the side of the handle of your knife, okay? After you will attach this first strap of the masking tape along the length of our shoe last, in the middle of the shoe last, attach another layer of this, of the masking tape, that will need to cover the first one approximately in a distance of 1 centimeter, 1.5 centimeters. Here in the heel, you should pull a little bit the edge of the masking tape in order to stretch it and attach it well without creation of folds. You will have here folds, of course, but you will have very small amount of folds if you will pull the masking tape. And attach this piece of masking tape on the bottom side of the shoe last. Try to avoid creation of folds. So to avoid folds, pull a little bit masking tape and attach it well to the first layer of our masking tape and to the side of the shoe last. Then you'll need to cut another strip of masking tape and attach it on the top surface of our shoe last. Pay attention to not create here many folds, so spread well our masking tape. An extra of masking tape you can cut out. Here in this tutorial, I wanted to show how to make basic pattern very fast, so I attach here masking tape only along the length of the shoe last. But to create very stable, strong masking tape pattern, you should attach same layers of masking tape along the width of the shoe last. Okay, so in the same way, just how you did it before, attach along the width of the shoe last, okay? After you will attach the second layer of the masking tape along width of the shoe last, you need to find the central line. In most of the cases, central line you need to find by eyes. Yes, there is certain technique how to find central line using shoemaking tape, but if you can, you can do it without shoemaking tape using your eyes. So what is important here is to find center on the top side of the shoe last, on the front part of the shoe last, and create and draw straight line that will divide your shoe last on two parts. To check if this line is straight, you need to observe it very well from two points of view. Then you will need to find central line on the back part of your shoe last. And here you need also use your eyes to find the central line exactly in the center of the heel part. And draw this line also, you need to draw here also straight line. To check if it's straight, observe it from two points of view and be sure that you made it correctly. After you will find these two central lines of your shoe last, you need to cut it out. And then you will need to cut the extra of the masking tape. Okay? Follow the lines with your utility knife and cut it out. It's very easy. Then you should find the feather line of your shoe last. If you have steel plate on your shoe last, follow the edge of the steel plate and cut masking tape where you have steel plate. If you don't have it, use this approach like I'm showing right now by drawing the edge of the shoe last with pencil. And then after you have this clear line, cut extra masking tape that you have on the front part of your shoe last. If it's very hard for you to cut with utility knife, you can create this kind of tool where you need to attach sandpaper, rough sandpaper on the wooden stick. And then you can use it in many steps of pattern making. For example, here, to know where is the exact line on the top side of our shoe last, use this stick. Okay, to sand it a little bit, and then if you didn't cut it well, use utility knife to cut this extra masking tape until the end. Then take off all extra of the masking tape, and then you need to take off this masking tape pattern from the shoe last and attach it to the cardboard. You see here we have one half of the basic pattern, and this is what we need to create basic pattern, because second half of this pattern we will create using this side, outer side of the shoe last. So take this masking tape pattern off from the shoe last, take it very slowly to not ruin your masking tape pattern. Be patient, don't pull it too much. And then after you take this masking tape pattern off, you need to attach it to the cardboard. There is certain approach how to attach it correctly without any mistakes, but here I show it without this approach. What is important here is to attach this masking tape pattern in the way where you will not have many folds in the along central line, like I am showing right now. You see here I don't have any folds. You will have folds on the bottom edge here in this place where we have most wide place on the shoe last. And to flat all these folds, to attach all these folds, pull them together with your fingers like I showed before and attach well this masking tape pattern. Then to have precise central line, use the ruler to draw central line in the front part of the masking tape. And then in the back part, you see I reduced a little bit the bottom edge of the masking tape pattern in 2 millimeters, approximately in 2 millimeters, from the bottom edge of the shoe last and make curved line. It's important to create very smooth curved line of the back line. Then we need to add certain amount of lacing allowance. In the back part, you need to add 20-22 millimeters. In the middle part, you need to add 18 millimeters. Okay, here we have 20-22, then 18, and in the middle of our basic pattern between previous point and between toe edge, you need to add 15 millimeters. And in the toe, for lacing allowance, if you have pointed toe last, it's enough to add only 10 millimeters. If you have rounded toe last, you can add 13-14 millimeters. And through all these points, create very smooth line that will connect between all these points, and this is how you will get lacing allowance. Then you can cut out your masking tape pattern following all lines. And after you will create this masking tape pattern attached on the cardboard, you should check it from paper. Why we use here paper? Because paper doesn't stretch. And this is the perfect way to check correctness of our basic pattern. So use simple paper A4, two pieces of this paper. Place your cardboard pattern on this paper and copy the outlines of your basic pattern. This is how we check all our patterns in my courses. First of all, you don't need to waste your leather. And second is the best way to check correctness of your basic pattern, because if you have some mistake, you will see it precisely working with paper. If you will make it from leather, leather stretches, and you will not see the mistakes that you can have in the pattern. So to attach two pieces of this pattern, paper pattern, we use same masking tape. Just cut strip of masking tape on half to have narrow strip of masking tape, because it will be easier to work with, and attach it on the back part like I did before, making small cuts along masking tape to bend it, to attach it on other side of paper and cut extra of masking tape. Then attach few pieces of same masking tape on the front part of our paper pattern. And to attach these masking tape straps in curved area of our pattern, we will need to make also cuts along this masking tape, like I am doing here. You see, just cut it and then attach to the other side of the paper pattern. And when you will attach your two parts of paper pattern, make sure that the edges of your paper connect precisely with each other. After you will attach two pieces of paper together, you need to crumple paper in order to place it and pull it on the shoe last, because if you will not crumple it, you will tear up this paper pattern. Okay, so crumple it well, and then you can place it on the shoe last. Here is very important to place it correctly. What I mean, the center line of your paper pattern in the front part of the shoe last must match the center line of the shoe last, and the back center line of paper must match the back center line of your shoe last. It's very important. So after you will place it on the right place, in the right place on the shoe last, you can attach edges of your paper with masking tape. You should pull it a little bit, don't pull it too much to not ruin your paper pattern. So just pull a little bit and attach edges of the masking tape to the shoe last bottom. Here in this place, you will have a small gap between paper and shoe last, because we have here curved line. So to attach it better, make small cut on the paper pattern and attach with masking tape. Okay, it must lay tightly on the shoelace. You see, this is how you can check if it has loose sides or not. Here in this place, for example, we can reduce a little bit our paper pattern. So that's why, to know on how much you need to reduce it, make a line, draw a line, and in the back, in the bottom edge of the, on the bottom edge of the shoelace here, we need to have gap on the distance of 2 millimeters, the gap between surface of the shoelace and paper pattern. We need this distance to place between upper and lining stiffener, so we need to have this small gap. Be sure that you attach your paper pattern well, and with the fingertip you can draw the bottom edge of the shoelace. And on the part, on the front part, to see precise this bottom edge of the shoelace, draw with pencil. We need to have this line of the inner side because we don't have it. We did only outer side pattern of the basic pattern. So that's why we should know what is lacing allowance and what is the bottom line on the inner side. If you see that your paper pattern extends, correct it. It extends here on the top side. Okay, so we need to reduce it a little bit. Be sure that you place it correctly before you will take it off. And then after you will check your basic pattern from paper like this, you can take off all pieces of masking tape. And you will have checked basic pattern. We checked it from paper. You see, the pattern was correct, and paper pattern, our basic pattern was correct, and paper pattern laid very well on the shoelace. And here in the back part, you saw that there was a small extra on the back, so we corrected, cut it out, and cut also on the top side if you have this extra as well. Now after you make this paper pattern, you can check it how it lays with the insole. If you have the insole, place the paper pattern and see that you have here the exact line. It will not reach the line of the edge of the insole because it's made from paper, but when you will make it from leather, it will stretch and you will have enough space to last it. After you take it off from the shoelace, transfer inner line of the shoe bottom on the outer side of the pattern with the edge of the knife, and then draw along these marks left from the knife the line with pencil. And you can mark it with another color of pen or pencil to see what is the line for inner side and what is the line for the outer side of your shoelace. And you also can make a mark for the inner line of your shoelace. Then take another piece of cardboard, and we will transfer this paper pattern to the new cardboard, piece of cardboard, to have the precise exact pattern of our shoelace, the basic pattern of our shoelace, with two lines of the shoelace, with the two lines of the bottom shoelace. Okay, now before you will place the paper pattern, use your previous cardboard pattern with masking tape in the way where you will transfer only the beginning of the back line and the beginning of the top line and also the central line, front central line. Then according to these lines, place your paper pattern. Why we need to have this reference? Because your paper pattern may may change the shape a little bit because you stretched it on the shoe last. That's why to know that you will place it correctly, use your first basic pattern, and then spread well and tie all folds that you will have on the paper, and attach your paper pattern with nails. After you will attach your paper pattern on the cardboard, copy all lines of your new basic pattern, the basic pattern that you have checked before a few minutes, okay? And then after you will copy the outlines of this basic pattern, also transfer the bottom line of the shoe last, the bottom line of the inner side, and the bottom line of the outer side with the edge of the knife. Transfer these two lines on the cardboard. We have small changes in the front part of the paper pattern, so you can transfer only front part of the edge of the shoe last, the inner side and the outer side. The back line will stay the same. It didn't change. Okay, so when you will transfer with the knife, draw these lines with pencil to see them clear, and then add lacing allowance to both these lines, to the bottom line, bottom edge of the outer side, and to the bottom edge of the inner side. We need to add same lacing allowance that allowances that we added before. In the toe area, we need to add 10 millimeters if we have pointed toe last. In the middle place between the most extended place of our shoe last and toe, we need to add 15 millimeters. In the most wide place here where I'm showing right now, we need to add 18 millimeters. And in the back, we stay with the same line, elastic allowance that we had because it didn't change. Okay, so add lacing allowance to both lines of our shoe last, to the outer side, to the line of our outer side of the shoe last, and to the bottom edge of the inner side of our shoe last, and then cut this basic pattern out. So you have here this difference between lacing allowance of outer side and inner side. And through the mark of the outer side of your shoe basic pattern, make cut to know where is the edge of this part, because we need to have it when we will construct all other patterns of different footwear types. Okay, this is the inner side, the outer side, and entire basic pattern. That's it. This is how you will make your basic pattern correctly. And I want to remind you that this basic pattern is very important pattern in construction of almost any footwear type except pumps, for example. But all other footwear types like moccasins, Oxford shoes, derby shoes, boots are constructed on this basic pattern. That's why it must be very precise and must be correct, because if you have here mistakes, you will have mistakes in your footwear ties that you will make working with this basic pattern. So do it correctly. And of course you will have questions, and I'm here to help you with all your questions, so comment below the video. Thank you. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell button to know when my new video will come out. See you in my next video. Bye.